The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Lord be with your dogs. And also with them. Okay. We just put out a couple of bowls of water. They're near the back. So if your dog would like a little drink in the middle of church, it's totally fine. There's little dog treats right there. So you can decide how many little treats they would like. And that would be great. Do we have any non-dogs present besides humans? Okay, because I know it's hard to bring other animals. But if you brought a picture of a pet, we're going to be blessing that. If you just want to close your eyes and imagine, remember your pet, and that's also fine. But this is the time for us. St. Francis of Assisi Day was on Friday, and it's always a great opportunity to just remember animals. St. Francis loved animals. He believed he could talk to them. He talked to the birds, and he was so in touch with nature. So this is our chance to remind ourselves that we're not the only ones God created. And good luck with all the lovely smells. Pay attention to this. Don't pay attention to that. Okay. Please rise as you are able as we begin our worship with a confession and assurance. God of all creation, you created us in love and created us for love. And you invite us to enjoy relationship with one another and with you. Forgive us, O God, when we fail to value relationships or when we hoard love as though it were a scarce commodity. Forgive us when we seek to blame others for failings that are ours. Help us to use our hands to do your work in service and love for our neighbor. Remind us, God, that you love us and expect us to love each other. Knowing ourselves loved, forgiven, and welcomed, may we be free to build our community here in this place and wherever we are. In the name of God, the Creator, Sustainer, and Redeemer. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
So you can wave. If you have a doggy or something, you can pat them. You can pat them. Welcome to them. Peaceable, whatever works for you. And now our gathering song is Here I Am to Worship. Holy God, we thank you for the gift of life, recalling St. Francis of Assisi, who celebrated your love for all creation. Today we embrace our connectedness with all. Yes, to wind and sea and sky, to earthworm, giraffe, and chicken, to fish and puppy, to cats of the jungle and in our homes. Deepen our care for all that lives in the name of Jesus, our teacher, savior, and friend. Amen. Amen. Yeah. And now it's time for the pet blessing.
Preach.
Yeah. Yes. This is probably greater wisdom than we can even understand. In Genesis, God created and blessed the animals of the sea, land, and sky. Then God created humans to care for the fish of the sea, the birds of the sky, the livestock, all earth, and all the crawling things on earth. As people of faith, we are called to care for God's animals in general and our pets in particular. If you brought a picture of your pet, I invite you to lift that up now or take a moment to think of your pet at home. If you brought your pet with you this morning, lay your hand on your animals now. And if you have no pets in your life right now, we invite you to still be part of this blessing for God's creatures. And we're going to read this part together where it says, state pet's name, do not say state pet's name. You're supposed to say, I know you. You're supposed to put in the name of your pet or pets. So let's say this together. Holy God, we thank you for the gift of Hans the Gretel in my household. Through this animal, you have brought many blessings. Today we pause to name our gratitude and to pray a blessing on all the animals we are touching and the animals we could not bring with us today. For the companionship of our pets, we say thanks. Bless the lives of these animals entrusted to our care. May they know loving care through all their days. Amen. Holy God, we lift to you the animal inhabitants of the earth, for those seen and unseen creatures and living things that attest to your creative power. We ask your blessing. We pray for victims of animal cruelty. Bless all who care for injured and abused animals. Comfort those who mourn for their pets who have died and for endangered and extinct species. We pray that companionship with household pets will deepen our care for animals everywhere. Help us to balance our needs with theirs and lead us in ways of life together that will be sustainable for all. We pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. And please remain seated as we say together the prayer of the day. Faithful God of an unfaithful people, the people of Israel doubted your power and turned to other gods to fulfill their needs. We too turn to other gods, seeking acceptance, power, and independence. Show us how to live humbly in you and walk in your ways. In the name of the one who offered true power to all humanity, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. So we're about to begin with our lessons. We'll be reading Psalm 8 responsively by whole verse. And I just wanted to know, sometimes when people have a baby in worship and the baby cries, they say, oh, I ruined worship because of a baby's cry. A baby's cry never ruins worship. And as we have pets and we hear barks, this is a day when we can just delight in the sound of barks. It's as one who just lost my pet this year. It's so nice to hear. So thank you for bringing your pets this morning. Thank you. That was an amen over there. O Lord our God, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
You whose glory is chanted above the heavens, out of the mouths of infants and children. You have set up a fortress against your enemies to silence the foe and avenger.
When I consider your heavens, the works of your fingers, the moon, and the stars you have set in their courses,
what are mere mortals that you should be mindful of them, human beings that you should care for them?
Yet you have made them little less than divine. With glory and honor you crown them.
You have made them rule over the works of your hands. You have put all things under their feet.
All flocks and cattle, even the wild beasts of the field,
the birds of the air, the fish of the sea, and whatever passes along the paths of the sea.
O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
Thank you.
The lesson today is from Exodus 32, verses 1 through 14. After the slaves were freed from Egypt, they were filled with fear for the future. By creating their own comfort in the form of golden gold calf, they turned away from God. When the people saw that Moses delayed to come down from the mountain, the people gathered around Aaron and said to him, "Come make gods for us, who shall go before us? As for this Moses, the man who brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we do not know what has become of him." Aaron said to them, "Take off the gold rings that are on the ears of your wives, your sons, and your daughters, and bring them to me." So all the people took off the gold rings from the ears and brought them to Aaron. He took the gold from them, formed it into a mold, and cast an image of a calf. And they said, "These are your gods, O Israel, who brought you up out of the land of Egypt." When Aaron saw this, he built an altar before it, and Aaron made proclamation and said, "Tomorrow shall be a festival to the Lord." They rose early the next day and offered burnt offerings and brought sacrifices of well-being, and the people sat down to eat and drink and rose up to revel. The Lord said to Moses, "Go down at once. Your people, whom you brought back out of the land of Egypt, have acted perversely. They have been quick to turn aside from the way that I have commanded them, and they have cast for themselves an image of a calf, and have worshipped it and sacrificed to it, and said, 'These are your gods, O Israel, who brought you up out of the land of Egypt.'" The Lord said to Moses, "I have seen this people, how stiff-necked they are. Now let me alone, so that my wrath may burn hot against them, and I may consume them. And of you I will make a great nation." But Moses implored the Lord his God and said, "O Lord, why does your wrath burn hot against your people, whom you brought out of the land of Egypt with great power and with a mighty hand? Why should the Egyptians say, 'It was with evil intent that he brought them out to kill them in the mountains and to consume them from the face of the earth'? Turn from your fierce wrath, change your mind, and do not bring disaster on your people. Remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, your servants, how you swore to them by your own self, saying to them, 'I will multiply your descendants like the stars of heaven, and this land that I have promised I will give to you, to your descendants, and they shall inherit it forever.' And the Lord changed his mind about the disaster that he planned to bring on his people." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So my young friends who are human can come forward. Young friends who are dogs can remain seated. You wouldn't get anything out. So when I was little, I would get scared at night, and literally this is how I would sleep at night. Now, do you think that protected me from all the monsters in my head and everything like that? Sometimes I'd make an air hole and sometimes let myself breathe, but I was so convinced that if I was covered up, that all the bad stuff wouldn't happen and no monsters would find me and I'd be safe. Does that make sense? It doesn't. Those are both good answers. Because a lot of times when we're scared, we don't think, we don't sometimes do things that are quite what we should be doing. And we forget that God is going to protect us no matter what. And we sometimes forget that. And in our story for today that we heard Amy read, there were people who were afraid that Moses wasn't going to come back, that God wasn't going to help them, that they're stuck in the wilderness, and they got scared. And so they essentially put a blanket over their head and made a golden calf and said, "This is our God." And they kind of forgot. It wasn't the wisest thing to do, but when we're scared, sometimes we don't say we don't think things through. There's plenty of times we kept too many examples to mention of times when we've been afraid and we've just rashly sort of done something like fight or flight or things like that. So we sometimes have to just slow things down and calm, take a deep breath and say, "God will protect me." And God will protect us. And we don't have to be afraid, and we don't have to throw a blanket over our heads. Some people maybe use a flashlight when they were scared at night, or a nightlight, or they would have a lovey that they would sleep with. And there's things that we do that make us feel safe, but the safest thing we can do is just trust in God. So we're going to ask God to help us when we're scared and maybe make better decisions by trusting God. So whatever I say, we can all say together. Ready? Dear God.
Dear God.
We are not always smart.
We are not always smart.
When we are scared.
When we are scared.
Remind us.
Remind us.
That you are with us.
That you are with us.
All the time.
All the time.
There is nothing to fear.
There is nothing to fear.
You are here.
You are here.
Amen. Yeah, so that's something to think about. You can go back to your seat and we'll have our next song. Instrument today. And we're adjusting. Thank you for being patient. Needed to contact the police. If I didn't know the family, if I just heard the basic information about them, I would have seen the situation in a different way, but I know this family, and I know their dynamics, and I found myself praying fervently that the one who was most hurt would find a way to forgive the one who lost their cool. My prayers were a series of pleas to God as I lay out a case for forgiveness Don't forget that they went through this. Don't forget that this happened. Lord God, help them to find forgiveness. Since forgiveness, I think, is the only way they're going to have healing in what is a very complicated relationship. And nobody wants to have trouble, but it happens. Nobody wants to make mistakes, but we do. If there's one thing we've learned so far in our lessons in the recent Sundays is that human beings are very fallible. Adam and Eve couldn't resist the fruit of the tree of knowledge. Abraham couldn't completely trust God to give him descendants with his wife Sarah, so he had a child with his wife's servant Hagar. The Egyptian Pharaoh's heart was hardened, and the firstborn of every family paid the price. Today we find ourselves in the wilderness with the freed slaves, and they too are getting into some trouble. Why? Right? If you just hear the basic story, like, Moses led them out of slavery and into the wilderness, you say, oh, they must be so grateful. They're out of trouble. This is fantastic. They must be so happy. No. You might think that, but nuh-uh. After being in the wilderness just a short time, they complained, we don't have any food. So Moses talked to God and they got manna. Manna's boring. So Moses talked to God and they got quail. We don't have anything to drink. So Moses talked to God and he gave him a stick and a rock and they got some water. They complained about life in Egypt being way better than life in the wilderness, seeming to forget the whole like slavery thing. At this point, they've been in the wilderness about 3 months. And Moses has gone up to Mount Sinai several times to try to talk to God about how to be expat people in the wilderness. And this was Moses' fourth trip up the mountain. At this point, he'd been gone 40 days and 40 nights. And that really is, that's a long time. Just think of how long 40 nights feels like sometimes. 40 days and 40 nights. So the people are getting antsy. So they turned to Moses' brother Aaron and asked him, come, make gods for us. Who shall go before us? As for this Moses, the man who brought us up out of Egypt, we do not know what has become of him. I think the Israelites felt scared and abandoned by God. Scared and abandoned by Moses. God was up there on Mount Sinai, removed from the people and removed from their anxiety. And where was Moses? He was nowhere to be found. So they forgot that it wasn't Moses who brought them out of Egypt. It was God who did that. They forgot that God had saved them from that deathly 10th plague through the Passover. They forgot that God had led them out of slavery and into freedom by a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. They forgot because they were waiting so long. I think we all have experiences with waiting that we don't like. Things we have to wait for things. How many of us thought COVID was finally over? It keep popping up again and again in different variants. Did you hear the government is now giving each household 4 free COVID tests again? They're back with that program because there's so much COVID out there. How much longer do we have to wait before that's going to be tamped down? And we all know people who are waiting for healing as they deal with cancer or tumors or other afflictions. And sometimes the healing doesn't follow the schedule of even the best doctors. It's a giant unknown what's going to happen tomorrow. So the folks in the wilderness gave up on waiting, took things into their own hands, gathered all their gold, and wanted gods. Yes, gods, like the ones that they had left in Egypt. The gods in the shape of a bull calf, like the Egyptian god Apis, or the Canaanite bull calf named Baal. They gave up on Moses. They gave up on God. They made their own. At this point in the story, I think we can read it and think, oh, I'm so much better than those Israelites. I would never worship a golden calf. We think we're too smart to fall for that. But we are just as vulnerable in our choices and our priorities as the ancient Israelites. Don't we often think that financial worth defines our value? That makes money into an idol. Don't we often find ourselves making idols out of political parties, out of power or prestige? Some people objectify others because of their gender or abilities. Or sexual orientation. Isn't that making an idol out of our prejudices? So if you still think No, I do not have any false idols. Let me ask you this. Can you survive without your cell phone? Can you get by without your keys? Shouldn't we rather want to keep God by our side instead of a cell phone or keys? But how many of us go crazy when we say, oh, I can't find my cell phone. I have to have my cell phone. Where are my keys? I can't go anywhere because they're my keys. We too have false gods that we have put above God, our Savior. Of course, when God saw the Israelites do this, God was going to be angry that their priorities were so out of whack. And that's the way we are sometimes too, if we're honest. Our priorities are out of whack. But God was so angry with them, he wanted to kill them. And then we hear the voice of the sympathetic ear. We hear Moses making a case for forgiveness. Even though maybe it didn't seem like they deserved it, Moses knew the people, and he wanted to present a case. He found out what they were doing down below, and he asked God to consider. Number one, God, please turn away from your anger against your people. You brought them out of Egypt. He reminded God that the people were his. And then number two, think of what the Egyptians would say about God who delivers the people from slavery only to kill them in the wilderness. That's basically what will the neighbors think, but still it worked. Moses offered that as a chance. Number three, remember your covenantal promises to Abraham, Isaac, and Israel to multiply their descendants like the stars in heaven. Reminding God of covenantal promises, that was a good call for Moses. Now this doesn't mean that Moses liked what they did. He wasn't condoning the wayward people. But he reminded God that though they might sometimes be unfaithful, God needed to remain faithful. And because of those pleas, God did not destroy them. God changed God's mind. I often have talks with people about the effectiveness of prayer, and I sometimes hear, why should I pray when God's going to do what God's going to do anyway? Well, here's your answer right here. God listened to Moses. And God's mind was changed. Just like God's mind was changed about destroying the people of Nineveh in the story of Jonah. Prayer makes a difference. God listens. And clearly God stands ready to offer forgiveness even when we are the ones who turn away. So open your eyes to see where God is reaching out to forgive your mistakes, to mend all of our relationships, to renew our hearts. Seek first the kingdom of God. Amen. And there are a few questions in the bulletin on page 8. Number one, Moses begged God to be merciful to the people who betrayed him. What was Moses concerned about? Number two, the people were impatient with God and took matters into their own hands. When have you benefited from waiting? Or perhaps been rash and paid a price? It's like when you waited or when you didn't wait and something happened. Since we have our animals with us, we don't need to have any discussions right here. We can talk with our animals later about this over lunch, perhaps. So I invite you now to rise as you are able as we confess together the Apostles' Creed, and then we'll go right into the prayers of intercession. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. After each petition, you will hear God in your mercy, and your responses hear our prayer. Anna is going to be reading the prayers. You can read the prayers next time for you.
Challenged by God's word in Christ, let us pray for the church, the world, and the whole creation. God of our ancestors, we give thanks for the church in all times. May we listen for your voice and wait patiently for your response. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Creator of every creature on earth, direct our lives towards the renewal and sustaining of cattle, birds in the air, animals in the field, and those who share our hopes. Reveal the ways we can work alongside creation for the health and well-being of all. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Sovereign God, we give thanks that you are mindful of us mere mortals. Accompany us when hardness of heart is in the way of justice between people and nations. Endow leaders with minds for justice and hearts for compassion. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Restoring God, work through medical professionals to diagnose, ease pain, and give life to all who seek wisdom and experience. Be with those facing the aftermath of Hurricane Helene. Grant healing and wholeness to those who are sick and suffering, especially among our members, Andrew, Carol, Helen, Norm, Glenn, Frankie, Matthew, Tim, Barbara, David, Margo, Jean, and among our friends, Mary, Jay and family, Debbie, Steffi, Mark, Norma, Julia, Matt, Mike, Aaron, David, Y.E., Rick, Brian, Mary, and Matt. And those who we remember silently in our hearts. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You define God, humans were created for relationship with others, its creatures and one another. Forgive us when division finds companionship. Be with those dealing with conflict like Ukraine, Russia, Artsakh, Turkey, Syria, Afghanistan, Haiti, Myanmar, Ethiopia, Lebanon, Belarus, Sudan, Israel, the Church of the Holy Land, particularly Jerusalem, and our siblings in Gaza. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of all, we pray for our leaders, Joe, Wes, and Brandon, for our presiding bishop, Elizabeth, as well as our Delaware, Maryland, Bishop Bill, and their staff. Unite us with our neighbors in Baltimore, our online mission field, and those in the 12-step programs offered at our coffee house. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of resurrection, you prepare a place in the kingdom through Christ's death and resurrection. We give thanks for the saints who have taken their place at your heavenly banquet, especially William Tyndale, translator and martyr, whom we commemorate today. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands, O God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in the saving grace you freely give, both now and forever.
Amen.
And be seated because there's some families. We'll do a communion party while we're seated. So the offering box is actually upstairs, but everything else you could do down here. If you were going to give online, there's the phone number. If you wanted to text a gift, if you wanted to mail a gift, you have to go home and get an envelope and a stamp. So there are half of the things you can do right here. Oh, you're going to go get the box? Thank you. Yeah, we have an offering box. I think Anna's going to run and get it. But we give of ourselves in so many different ways. And now we're going to have our offering prayer. Let us pray. Blessed are you, O God, source of every gift of your creation. By these gifts and with our lives, help us to serve one another and all in need through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. And just keep being seated. So keep our animals happy. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, O God, our Father and Mother, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Holy, mighty, and merciful Lord, heaven and earth are full of your glory. In great love you sent to us Jesus, your Son, who reached out to heal the sick and suffering, who preached good news to the poor, and who, on the cross, opened his arms to all. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and ascension, we await his coming in power. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share in this heavenly food, the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Amen. And now gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Christ invites us to this holy feast, and all are welcome. You don't have to be a member of this congregation. You don't have to be a Lutheran. The gifts of God are free. Jesus welcomes you to this table. Come. Here is God. I'd like to remind you that if our animal friends want a sort of kind of a table meal, there's still snacks and there's water in the bag.
Thank you.
Was there any dog beholden person who didn't get to come forward who we should bring communion to? Just checking. Okay.
Sure.
Then we pray together the prayer after communion. It's found on page 13. We pray this together. Holy God, you have welcomed us to this meal and fed us with dignity at your table. Send us now to welcome others and to be at peace with one another. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
So we have several different kinds of announcements that are in here. First, I have to say hey to Juliana. Nice to have you back with us. Yeah. Our famous opera singer is spending time with us. It's so lovely. Thank you. It's just always good to worship with you, and we love your family, of course. So we have different Bible studies going on, and we have adult forum continuing. Wanted to remind everybody we have church council that's coming up, and still, Tim loves cards. And you can see him and say, hey, send him a card anyway. He loves it. Over there on the tape, on the piano, we are going to be collecting noisy change offering. And the idea is to collect any change that you would like to give. This is for ELCA World Hunger, which is celebrating 50 years. And we thought this would be a good way to do that. So throughout October and November, which are honestly, those are eating months, right? I mean, you can smell. This is an eating month. I mean, there's candies and there's Thanksgiving and there's eating months. So we want to think about advocating for people who could use a little bit of help with food. To give help, Manor House is looking for help. There's information about that. There is The Chosen is being shown still by Claim, and if you'd like to join, just pop over, and it's great. It's a great conversation to have there too, to watch an episode and then have a conversation about this. This is a mini series about Jesus for them. There's a free lecture, but you have to go to Frederick. It's on white supremacy. It's part of the Dr. Eric Rich and Bonnie Probst Memorial Lecture, so we just wanted to make sure people knew about that. And just to have this on your calendar, the last Sunday of October, the 27th, we are not going to be here. We are going to be worshiping with our brothers and sisters at St. Mark's. So we'll have a bigger group together celebrating Reformation Sunday. I also wanted to remind everybody who's here for confirmation, I know you can spell all the lovely spells. You don't have confirmation right after worship. You can enjoy a little bit of coffee hour. We'll give you like 15 minutes to, you don't have to stuff your face either because totally bring food with you, but we're going to be meeting in the library. Everybody who's here for confirmation. Are there any other announcements that should be made? Okay, Paul.
Lou and I would like to thank you all for making recipe contributions. So, but we haven't like grown to press yet, so if in the Lutheran tradition of grace, if you still have them, you'd like to give us, please.
I like that. In the Lutheran tradition of grace, if you want to turn in a late recipe, that's okay. Lulu says it's okay, so it's okay. That's nice. I do also want to thank everybody who was involved. The lovely smells that you're smelling are because we had a wonderful time with our Oktoberfest. Everybody who was here had a great time. Everybody who worked, thank you so much. There's some of the people who are still working. They've been working all night. They never left. They live here. So we want to thank them for all of this because we're the beneficiaries of some leftovers. So, oh my gosh, you are going to be so happy. So those are our announcements, and now we're going to. Go ahead.
So in the habit of singing for people's birthdays, it's Eric's birthday
today. Oh. I sort of sometimes look at the bulletin. I'm sorry. Okay, let's say happy birthday to Eric.
Nice. Today's your birthday.
Yeah. If it's on the Sunday, we have to. Okay. Ready?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Eric. Happy birthday to you.
Any other
birthdays? Any dog birthdays? Thank you. Okay, all right. But we like to celebrate. We are a family. We like to celebrate the special times in our life. So now our blessing and our commissioning. As we prepare to step back into the world, may we find beauty and joy in all that we see and in the people and dogs and animals that we encounter. Breathe deep. Open your eyes. See the work of our Creator. And may you know God's blessing this week. Amen. Our sending song is Great is the Lord, then Confirmands. You have 15 minutes and then I want to sing in the library. Alright?
So since we have a wonderful singer with us, we get to enjoy having you. Having a
Stay here for a minute and eat.